Hi everyone, welcome back. Today I'm going to be walking you through how to create a stage leaderboard and stage checkpoints in Roblox for obbys. So the first step is, of course, open up your Roblox studio or whatever project you're currently working on. The next step is, in the explore side on the right, we're looking for a folder that says teams, but as you see right now, I do not have the teams folder. If you have the folder that says teams, you can skip this next part. So in order to add the teams folder, you have to click model at the top, and then all the way near the right side, there's some gear icons that say service. We're gonna click on that, we're gonna have a box that comes up. And in this box, as you can see, there is an option that says teams. We're gonna click on that, and then click insert. And now, as you see on the right, the teams folder is now inserted. Now, in order to set up the leaderboard part, we're gonna use teams. The teams functionality. So for each stage of your obby, you're going to want to create a new team for it. So let's create a team. When you're going to hit the little plus button next to teams, and then you're just going to click on team, and it'll add a new team. So let's call this first one stage one. And let's set its color to this red, really red, one of my favorite colors in Roblox. Oh, I spelled stage wrong, so let me fix that. Satage 1. Let me change that to stage 1. Still spell Satage. Stage 1. And now let's add another one for stage 2. And let's click on that one we just added. And then let's call this one stage 2. And hit enter to submit the name, and then let's change this one to blue, dark blue. It's a good one. And now in these teams, we have stage one and stage two now. There's in each of them, under the data section in the properties panel, there is a section that says auto assignable with a checkbox next to this. The only team that we want the checkbox checked in is the first one. So that when the player spawns, they'll be set as the first stage. So in everyone besides stage one, we want to uncheck auto assignable. So if I added a third team and called it stage three, still can't spell stage, let me fix that. Stage three, and let's set this one to yellow, or a new yeller, I should say. And we have to uncheck auto assignable since it is not the first stage. And now let's hit play. And on the right side of the screen, there will now be a leaderboard with different sections for each different stage of the map. And that's awesome. But now we can't change teams. Now the next function is to add different checkpoints. So we will switch to the different stage when we get to the next section of the obby. So let me stop playing. And of course, the next thing we have to do is start adding some checkpoint or spawn points. So in the top of the screen, we're going to go back to the model section. And then all the way near the right side, right next to effects, there's a spawn. We'll click that and it'll create a new spawn point for us. So we want one spawn point for each stage. Since I have, as you can see, three stages on the right side, I'm going to make three different checkpoints. There we go. And I'm going to have this closest one be stage one, middle one be stage two, and last one be stage three. But now, if I hit play, it's a little demonstration. If I step on the spawn points, nothing happens. I'm not changing teams at all, since we haven't connected them to their actual stages yet. In order to connect the spawn points to their stages, all we have to do is let's click on the first spawn point. So I clicked on my first one. This is the one I want to be stage one. And then in the properties panel, we're going to scroll down and eventually we'll find a section called teams. And in this section, we're going to have to set the team color as the same team color we set for stage one. So I set it for really red. So let me scroll back down to teams. And I have to set this one to really red. Now, as you can see, that didn't change the actual color of the block. What I always like to do is I set the color of the brick to the same color as the team, just so I know what stage that checkpoint is for. And then in the team section again, in the properties panel, there's two other sections. There's neutral and allow team change on touch. We want to checkbox every single one for allow team change on touch, because that will, when the player touches the spawn point, change it to their to that stage. And we want to uncheck neutral, since we don't need a neutral team. So for each spawn point, what you're gonna do is you're gonna click on it, scroll down to the team section if you're not already there. We're gonna check allow team change, uncheck neutral, and change the team color to the stage we want. And this one, I want it to be stage 2. So let me open stage 2, and I set that to dark blue. So let me click on my second spawn point again, scroll down, and change the team color to dark blue. And as I said earlier, I always like to change the brick color to the same color, just so I know what spawn point is which. So I'm gonna set that to dark blue also. And now let's do the same thing for the last one. And let me just check the color really quick. So stage 3, I set as new yeller. So let me re-click on the third spawn point. I'm gonna change the brick color to new yeller. And then I'm going to scroll down and find the team section. Check, allow team change, uncheck neutral, and then team color, I want to be new yeller. And so now, when I hit play, we should spawn on the first checkpoint for stage 1. There I am, first checkpoint for stage 1. And if I walk over to the second stage, it sets me to stage 2. And then I can walk over to the third stage. And there we go. Now you're on stage 3. So that was a very simple and easy way of setting up obby checkpoints and an obby leaderboard for your Roblox game. Now, some extra things you can do if you wanted to. You can always change these stage names to whatever you want. They don't have to be stage 1, they don't have to be stage 2, they don't have to be stage 3. You can call them whatever you want. So if your first level is like, let's say, first level we're going to call Crazy Stairs. And then our second stage, we can call Lava Pool. And our third stage, we can call, let's call the third stage Big Cat, since we can name whatever we want. And now, when I click on play, it'll change the names in the leaderboards to what we just set the stage names as. See, Crazy Stairs was stage 1, now it's Crazy Stairs. Stage 2 is now Lava Pool, and the last stage is now called Big Cat. There we go. And then if you ever wanted to add any more stages to an obby, all you would do is you would click the plus on teams, add another team, the whole process all over again. Let's name this one, let's name this last stage Final. It's all caps Final. And we're gonna have team color be this dirt brown. And then we go back to model, and then we're gonna add another spawn point and do the same thing as before. When the spawn point is selected, scroll down to the team section right here, allow team change, uncheck neutral, and then change the color to the same one as the stage, which was dirt brown. And I'm also gonna change the brick color. And when I hit play, we should have a new stage added to the leaderboard and a new checkpoint ready to go for that stage. I'm on red, Crazy Stairs. You can see the final is in the top right corner now. Lava Pool, third stage, I'm gonna hit is Big Cat. And then the last stage I'll hit is Final. And there we go. And that is how you add a stage leaderboard and stage checkpoint for an obby in Roblox. And I will see you guys next time.